A question I get asked a lot is, why don't we put a plus C for definite integrals like we do for indefinite integrals? Because instructors are so adamant you have to put the plus C for an indefinite integral, but then when you turn right back around and do a definite integral, then they say, oh no, it's not important. Don't worry about putting one then. Well, I just want to illustrate this real quickly. So here's a simple example for taking an indefinite integral of 2x. Then the antiderivative or the indefinite integral would be x squared plus c, right? We know that. That's what we should write. But if we were doing a definite integral where we put limits of integration from a to b, then the integral would be just x squared. We put a bracket with an a and a b. So where does this plus c go? Why don't we put it for definite integrals? Where the answer is this. You actually could if you wanted to. It just turns out to be irrelevant. It doesn't matter. And here's why. If you had a plus c, and here I'll show you an example here. If we wanted to integrate 2x, let's say from 1 to 3, and so we take our antiderivative and we put a plus c, x squared plus c, bracket with a 1 and a 3 or what have you. And so we plug in a 3 and we plug in a 1. So here we go. I'll do this right here. So we'll plug in a 3, and then we'll plug in a 1, and then we'll subtract. So 3 squared is 9. Now, I don't know what this mystery c is, so I just have to leave it plus c. So 9 plus c, and then you plug in a 1, and you'd get 1 plus c. So distribute the negative. We get 9 plus c minus 1 minus c. And herein lies the issue. Every one of these definite integrals, regardless of who you're integrating or what the limit is, you would always wind up with a plus c minus c, and they would negate each other. And at the end of the day, you just have 9 minus 1, right? And so you just write your answer as 8. So if we know that we're going to plug in your upper limit and plug in your lower limit and subtract, then you're going to get a c minus a c. Every time, 100% of the time, it's just kind of silly. Why even write it? We can just write x squared, right? The antiderivative of 2x is x squared on the interval from 1 to 3. And then you don't have to fool with just writing a bunch of extra things that are, really irrelevant.